Hey everybody, this is Nick, and I got a great question from Bartomi over on YouTube on one of our videos on how to analyze a select all that apply question, but when there is an other option and you're using Microsoft Forms. So if I scroll down here on this video, we'll see Bartomi's first question here. Fantastic video, thank you. And how would you deal with the other option? If someone selects the other option, the actual word other does not show up in the file. And so this is what we're talking about over here, a question that is multiple select from Microsoft Forms. You see that you have several options here that you can select more than one. And then if you have an other and you specify that this is an other option in Microsoft Forms, it doesn't spit out the word other in your export. It will have whatever you write in here. You could write in bananas and then submit that question, and that bananas will show up in your export. Now we know from our previous video, make sure to go watch the video above so that you can see a quick little Excel trick to go ahead and analyze those select all that apply data from Microsoft Forms. You see that Microsoft Forms will export all of those multiple select data just like this. All of the options that are selected are concatenated together in one cell, squished together in one cell, and they're separated by semicolons. And they're in order of the selections, but there's not a really great way to sort of separate them. So we need a way to separate them in order to analyze them so that we can have them in this format right here, this binary one or zero format in each column. So each column is its own response option from the select all that apply survey or the multiple select survey item. Now this is where that other would show up. Now in this case here, this is my sort of dummy data export from Microsoft Forms. Right here, let's see, guavas was not an option. So I know that guavas would be something that somebody put in the other category. Now, when you have that write-in category, somebody might put in more than one thing for a text option as well. So here you can see they said guavas and pears as the last option. The other thing you'll notice is that in Microsoft Forms, everything ends with a semicolon as well. So we need a way to sort of separate these out. And here is the trick, Bartomi. There's gonna be a few different functions and formulas that we're gonna use along the way. So I'm going to scroll over here just a little bit. I'm going to keep my format right here. I'm going to scroll over there. Now what we want to do, actually what I think I might do is just hide these columns. So I'm going to right click and hide these columns just so that we can be a little closer to our export right here. The first thing we want to do is remove this trailing semicolon, the final semicolon we need to remove. So I'm going to go ahead and do this from this formula here. We're going to say equals left. That will return whatever is on the left. And then I'm going to click in, it's gonna say, what text do I wanna refer to? I'm gonna say E4, comma, and then another formula, L-E-N. L-E-N, the len formula, counts the number of characters in a cell. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on that. And we're gonna do this, and close the parenthesis there. Select, minus one, and then I think that's all we have to do. Let's push enter and see what happens. It says we found a typo. It needs one more closed parenthesis. So you just want to close the parenthesis on the end of that formula. Check out this formula right up here. So left, refer to the cell, comma, len, open parenthesis, refer to the cell again, minus one, close that parenthesis. And now you see that there is no trailing semicolon. There's no final semicolon there. So I'm going to go ahead and copy this down. Now what we need to do is we need to return the last word in each of these cells. So whatever the last word in the cell is, because I know the last word is going to be the other option when somebody has selected an other option, I'm going to go ahead and do this really long formula that will return the last word or phrase from this. And you're just gonna have to trust me here. I will paste these formulas and functions down in the comments, in the description of this video as well. Let me go over here. I kind of wrote it down here on my left just to be a little cheat sheet for me. So we're gonna go ahead and say equals trim, open parenthesis, write, open parenthesis, substitute, open parenthesis. Now we're gonna refer to our cell. In this case, I'm gonna refer to N4. I wanna refer to the cell without that trailing semicolon. And then we're gonna comma, put in quotes a semicolon. We're gonna substitute that semicolon for some spaces. We're gonna do the comma and then REPT, the rept, open parenthesis, put a space in quotes. So it's open quote, space, close quote, comma, and then we'll do the len function again. And then refer to N4 again, close that parenthesis one, two, three times, put another comma, do another len function, refer to N4, 1, close parenthesis, 2, close parenthesis, 3, close parenthesis, and now we're going to push enter and see and pray what happens. Push enter. Yes, it returns guavas. Guavas is the final word in this thing. Now let's go down and copy this down the list here. Yes, it returned the last bit of text. Any text after that final, after that semicolon, that last semicolon, it will return here. So you can see guavas and pears, it will return a phrase too. It won't just return that final word, it returns the phrase. Now, we know that this group of text here, it's not all of those other responses, because sometimes if somebody didn't put an other response over here, then it's just going to return whatever the responses that they selected in the list. And the last response in this cell is going to be the last response from our selection list. So what we want to do is just make sure that we know all of our options from that multiple select question were apples, oranges, kiwis, and grapes. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to replace all of those words with nothing, with just kind of a general blank cell. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to highlight this column. You can highlight however many you want, and we're going to go up to the find and select over on the home tab. Find and select, and we're going to click on replace. Now this is the find and replace menu. So right here, I'm going to go ahead and type apples. And I'm going to go ahead and say replace all. Wait a second, it says we couldn't find anything to replace. Why is that? Let's close out of this. The reason is because if you click in these cells and go up to the formula bar, you can see this is still a live formula. You won't be able to replace words in a cell if those are coming from a live formula. So let's go ahead and just copy this. We're gonna do Control C to copy, and we're gonna paste them in as values. So Control Shift V will give you just values. So now when I click in this cell and I look in the formula bar up here, guavas is the text that's written. So now we know this is perfect. This is just text. It's no longer formulas. So let's go ahead and do that find and replace again. Replace there, and apples, replace. And yes, we've done. We've made two replacements. Excellent. So now I'm going to go ahead and replace oranges with nothing. Three replacements made. And now we're going to do kiwis. Replace all, three replacements made, and now we will do grapes. Replace all. All right, and now we have our other responses. Let's go ahead and copy these, and let's go ahead and paste them into our data table over here. Control Shift V right there. Grapefruit now, this is great. Now I'm gonna go ahead and unhide the cells, we're gonna unhide those. And so here was our data table there. These are the normal responses that we had in our multiple select. Now, if I wanted to do the ones and zeros in this other column, we could do that with an if formula if we wanted to. So I'm gonna say equals if, open that parenthesis. We're gonna use the count A formula that tells us if there's something in a cell. Open the parenthesis, refer to this cell right here, close that parenthesis and say equals one, and then another comma will return a one, if true, and if false will return a zero. Close that parenthesis. And there we go, there's a one. Now if I copy this down, we should see some ones and zeros. Excellent, so there's nothing in this cell, so we see a zero. There's something in this cell, banana, so we see a one. So now I can go ahead and just copy my sum formula over. That's gonna sum the column, and now we can analyze this question. Eight people have selected an other response, and if we wanted to know what those other responses were, we have our list in write-in comments right there. So Bartomi, this was a little bit of a roundabout way to get there, but if you have Microsoft Forms data and you have to deal with select all that apply data or multiple select data in Microsoft Forms specifically or some other program that concatenates all of those responses into one cell, this is how you can do it. I'm gonna go ahead and paste those critical formulas in the description of this video so you can just go ahead and copy and paste them into your spreadsheet, and hopefully this works. You can pause, start, as many times as you need for this. So if anyone out there else found this helpful, please give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. I had a great time making this for you, and I can't wait to see you next time.